Hello everyone, my name is Denis and today we're gonna talk about Innoviva Incorporated with ticker INVA. Market cap $1.4 billion, income $188 million, and sales $284 million. Employees 5 people. Long-term debt to equity around 1. Price to earnings really good right now, that's why I'm thinking to buy this stock. Here you can see their portfolio and actually they are not selling it by themselves, as they got a partnership with another big company. Here how the stock looks on a guru focus, and we can see that they were not really good, but after they got a partnership with GSK, and now I think it is everything okay with the stock. Assets and liabilities. Total assets $788 million, and liabilities lower than 400, and they have lots of accumulated deficit, and they can write lots of income in the future. Total stockholders equity $400 million, and market cap 1.4, a little bit overpriced. And here you can see that royalty revenue from related party net of amortization of capitalized fees paid to a related party of blah blah blah, and they got $78 million, and operating expenses only $2.5 million. This is super nice. And here we can find the description of operations. Innovia is a company with a portfolio of royalties that include respiratory assets partnered with Glaxo Group Limited, GSK, including Revlar, Breva, Elliptia, Anoro Elliptia, and Trelegy Elliptia. Under the long-active beta-2-agonist LABA collaboration agreement, Innoviva is entitled to receive royalties from GSK on sales of their drugs as follows: 15% on first $3 billion of annual global net sales, and 5% for all annual global net sales above $3 billion, and royalties from the sales of Anora, which tire upward at a range from 6.5% to 10%. Innoviva is also entitled to 15% of royalty payments made by GSK under its agreement originally entered into with us. And since assigned to Trevon's respiratory company, LCTRS, including Trelegy and any other products of a combination of products that may be discovered or developed in the future under the LABA collaboration agreement and the strategic alliance agreement with GSK, which have been assigned to TRC other than their main drugs. And they are really far away from getting $3 billion, and I think we will see like 5 years of very nice income. I really like that they're trying to making something else, and they bought like 46.7% of Armata stock. The buy price was around 2.87 per share, and now Armata cost a little bit more, like $3 plus. Also, we have a new chief executive officer. It is a Pavel Rehfeld. I think that fresh blood is always good for company, and this fresh blood really experienced. I think it is a plus for this company. And we can see that institutional ownership is 74%, and we can see Renaissance Technology, Vanguard Group, BlackRock, and Morgan Stanley bought some shares. So here you can see the chart, and it's really hard to comment it, but I think we have some kind of upper trend here, but not really super strong. And the thing that I really don't like, it is a September options. We can see a put options for 10,000 on $10, $8 and $5. It is some kind of pressure, but from the other side we have the same amount on $10 strike but call option. It is strange. I will put the stock on my watch list and maybe something interesting will happen here. In my list I will write it yes to buy super risky, and I hope this video was helpful. Please push like button, subscribe button, and if you have lots of money you can support me on Patreon. Bye bye.